Hi student, welcome to botany class. Today we are going to see the teratopites or teratopyta. In the previous video we have discussed about the bryophyta, general characters, classification and economic importance of bryophyta. So these are the things we already discussed in the previous video. Now we are going to see the teratopyta. So it is a vascular cryptogamy. Teratopyte. It's a vascular cryptogamy. And also it's come under the embryophyta. So what is the embryophyta? After the zygote formation, the zygote is undergoing the repeated mitotic division. As a result, is formed the embryonic stage. From there, the new sporopathic plant body will be formed. Okay, so those plant is how the embryonic development be. The particular plant is come under the embryophyta. And cryptogamy, non-flowering, non-seeded plant. So teratopyta is a spore-producing plant, not seed-producing, spore-producing plant. And it's a vascular cryptogamy, tracheopyta. Teratopyta is come under the tracheopyta. That means it contains the connective tissues, xylem and the phloem. Bryophyta is a first land plant, but it is consists of amphibian of the plant kingdom. It is an intermediate between the aquatic form and the land form. But the well differentiated root, stem and leaves, we can see in the advanced form of teratopyte. But primitive form is not have like that. But the advanced form of teratopyte is the well differentiated root, stem and leaves. But in bryophyta, there is no true root, stem and leaves. But the root-like structure, that is rhizoids, is present. The rhizoid is helped, especially in bryophyte. The rhizoid is helped for to attach the thallus on the substratum. Okay. So, now we are going to see the teratopyta. So, they are your first plant to acquire the vascular tissues, namely xylem and phloem. Xylem is able to connect the water and the mineral salt from the root to all the part of the plant body. Phloem itself to conduct the food material from leaves to all the part of the plant body. And it is a vascular cryptogamy. So vascular means it has a connective tissues like xylem and phloem is present. Cryptogamy, non-flowering, non-seeded plants. So some of the plants or come under this teratopyta, that is club mosses, hostile, queen rock, water ferns and tree ferns. So these are the various type of teratopyte. It's all classified under teratopyte. So first we see the club mosses. So it's additional information, it's not given or book, you just know that. Club mosses. So they are low evergreen herbs. Low evergreen herbs with needle-like leaves or scale-like leaves. The leaves may be needle-like or scale-like. They are also called the ground pine plant, generally called. The club mosses generally called ground pine plant. Many species have the cone-like cluster of small leaves, that is a strobile, cone or strobile. So that is the yellow color, it will indicate. Strobile or cone-like structure. These plants are homosporous. The club mosses, the spore or the spore, all the club mosses plants are homosporous. That means the spores are identical in the structure, in the form. Next, hostile. So this plant is look like a tail of horse. That's what it's called, it's a hostile. They are very primitive plant. It look like a tail of horse. That's why it's called it's a hostile. The plant is consist of long, hollow, narrow stem. Long stem with the hollow, that means the empty space. It presents on the center of the stem and a narrow stem segment. The plant are homosporous. So these plants also have a homosporous stem. Quill rods, that is, it's a isolatus is commonly known quill rods. So they are herbaceous, spore-bearing plant with the grassy spike-like leaf. So the leaf is look like a grass leaf, that is spike. So spike means the group of origin from a single. Okay, so it's a spike like structure, but it's look like what? Grass like leaf. They are spirally arranged in the coil like leaves. So the leaves arranged in a spiral. So that's why it looks like a coil. So it's a coil rods. They are heterosporous. The coil rods are heterosporous. That means the two types of spores are formed. Microspores and the megaspores. Microspore is consists a male spore. Megaspore is consists a female spore. The male spore, that is microspore, germinate to form male gametophyte or male prothallus. The megaspore is germinate to form female gametophyte or female prothallus. Okay, so two type of spores are present, that is heterospores. Next, the water form. It is a small aquatic form. Okay, so Azolla is best example, small aquatic form. Next, the tree form. It is relatively primitive form. Most of them is characterized by the ascending trunk. So trunk means a woody part. It present grow above the soil level, like stem, and arborescent, that is tree like. Arborescent means tree like habitat. So that is the word. The tree forms. It's not a tree. It is a tree forms. Look like. Because it has the ascending stem and the arborescent, that is a tree like habitat. Next, origin of the teratopyte. It is a vascular cryptogam. We already know that. It's abundant in the Devonian period of Paleozoic era. That is nearly 400 million years ago. Dominant. Abundant means dominant. Is majority of the earth surface, it covered with this group of the plant. When it will majority cover? At the Devonian period of Paleozoic era. Listen. So that is a geological time scale for botany related. So here, the earlier vascular plant is appeared about the 410 million years ago. So that is especially the Paleozoic Devonian period. Paleozoic Devonian period, it will be originator. So Paleozoic Devonian. So there is the seedless vascular plant, that is a fern hostile. So this one, it is indicated. Okay, so here the different group of plant where it is origin. So here they will be give that the scale like structure. Okay, so it is algae it will be for algae it will be from the initial stage, that is Paleozoic era. And then bryophyte, that is a carboniferous bryophyte, and teratopyte is a Devonian period. Okay, so next is gymnosperm and the angiosperm, this is all given here. But we will only see about the teratopyte, it will be originated from the Devonian period, that is a Paleozoic era, Devonian period, nearly 400 million years ago. These plants are mostly small herbaceous. The plant grow only a certain level, a certain height, and it do not have any woody stem, that is a herbaceous. It grow well in moist, cool and a sandy place. It is a soil loving plant, where the water is available. It is very, very important. It is a first terrestrial plant, but it is also grow in the moist, cool and a sandy place like in bryophytes. The plant body is a sporophyte. Already I told you, plant body is a sporophyte. So that is a sporophytic plant body. It will be differentiated into root, that is a stem and the leaves. So it is a root, it is a modified stem, that is rhizome, modified stem. And then the leaf-like structure. That is a fawn, it is generally called fawn. The plant body is a sporophyte, that is a diploid. It is a dominant phase. But in gymnosperm, we already learned, the gametophyte is a dominant phase. But here, the sporopathy phase is dominant and it depends into root, stem and leaves. The root are adventitious. Adventitious means the primary root, it will be replaced by some other root, that is adventitious root. The stem shows monopodial or dicotomous branching. Monopodial means there is no branches, it grow only the stem. There is no branches. But dicotomous. So in dichotomous, so it will be divided into two branches. It is a single branch, from that the two branches form. Each two branches produce again two branches like that. Die means two, quatermers. So it will clear in two branches. The leaves may be microphyllous and megaphyllous. So here we can know one thing. So the leaves, there are two types of leaves. The scale leaves and the foliage leaves. Okay, the foliage leaves, it may be microphyllous and megaphyllous. So here the phyllus, it will be indicate what is the leaf. Microphyllous, that is a minute leaf or small leaves. Megaphyllous, that means the large leaves. Okay. The stele. So another anatomical structure, we can see the stele. So stele means the arrangement of vascular tissues in the stem and the root, that is a stele. So the stele or protostele, proto, that is a basic stele. Center, it has the xylem, xylem surrounded by the phloem. The recto indicates the xylem and it will be green color indicates the phloem. Okay, that is a protostele, that is a basic stele. And siphonostele is seen in the marsilia. Siphonum means the leaf gap is present. That is a siphonum or solenostele. The tracheid or the major water conducting element. Tracheid or the major water conducting element in all pteridophyte except in Selaginella vessels are found. It is very, very important. Need oriented question. Okay, which group of pteridophyte have the vessel in xylem tissues? That means Selaginella. So generally the tracheids are very common water containing elements in all pteridophytic plant except the Selaginella vessels are present. So the vessel, the presence of vessel is a characteristic features of angiosperm. Even the native of gymnosperm have the vessel, but it is very important character for angiosperm. The particular character, it will be present in the in this group Selaginella, that is a vessel. Next is sporangia, that is a bag like structure. Sporangia means plural form, sporangium means singular form. The spore bearing bag like structure or bone and special leaves, that is called sporophyll. So megaphyll, microphyll, that means small leaves and large leaves. Here the sporophyll, microsporophyll, megasporophyll. That means the fertile leaves is called sporophyll. Spore bearing leaf is called sporophyll, or sporangia bearing leaf is called sporophyll. The sporophyll are get organized to form cone or strobilize. Example, Selaginella ecosystem. Okay, so that is a strobilize or the cone like structure. This is sporangia, bag like structure. Inside is other spores. When the sporangia is mature, it will be split open as such as release the haploid spores. The spores, it may be a homosporous or heterosporous. Already I told you, what is a homosporous? The spores are similar. The spores are similar in form. Only one type of spore. Example, Lycopodium. In heterosporal, two types of spores are formed. One is, when comparatively in the morphological structure, it will be differ. One is small spore, another is large spore. Second, it will be clearly given. It is a sporophytic plant body is produced. That is a microspore, it's a megaspore. The two types of spore. Okay, so each is developed into corresponding gametophyte. Mega mean, mega gametophyte or female gametophyte. Micro mean, micro gametophyte or male gametophyte. Example, Selaginella. So, it's produced a two type of spore, heterospores. Heterospore is the origin of seed habitat, that is really important. So the presence of the heterospore, it is a basic for the seed habitat in higher group of plants, where it is originated from the pteridophyte. The development of sporangia. So based on that, it will be classified into two types, eusporangia, leptosporangia. Eusporangia means the group of initial, the group of cell, which is responsible for formation of sporangia. So listen, here the group of cell. So this group of cell, later it will be changed into the sporangium. But in leptosporangia, single cell, is act as initial to form the spore. So here, lepto. Single cell, it forms the sporangium. That is a lepto. U mean group of initial, lepto mean single initial. The spore mother cell, inside the sporangium, the spore mother cell is undergoing the meiosis. That is reduction division. As a cell, it forms the four haploid spore. That is a spore tetrad. Okay. Later, these spores are germinated to form the haploid multicellular green chordate. Chordate means hot cell. Chordate cell means independent gametophyte prothallus form. When the spores are germinated to form haploid multicellular green chordate cell, independent gametophyte prothallus is formed. So that is, it's a sorus, that is a sporangium, the haploid spores are formed after the reduction division. These spores germinate to form the prothallus. It is a what? Chordate cell. It's a chordate cell. It is an independent gametophyte. That means it do the self mode of nutrition. It look like a green in color. So in the gametophyte, it has the male and the female sex organ. That is, male sex organ is called antheridium. Female sex organ is called oligonium. The antheridium is produced in the multiflagellator anthrozoite. The oligonium, it formed the egg, haploid egg. Okay, so the anthrozoite, that is multiflagellator anthrozoite, it is swimming the water and reach to the oligonia. Because they have the flagella, no? So it will swimming the water and reach to the oligonia. And the fecalization or thin gamete is occur as a form the diploid zygote. So next, vegetative reproduction. So what are the vegetative reproduction is occur? Fragmentation, resting bud, root tuber, adventitious bud. So these are the vegetative reproduction is occur in the tetrapod. Next is sexual reproduction. The reproduction is oogamous. Oogamous means the male gamete is comparatively very, very smaller than the female gamete. So female gamete is very huge or very large in size. Male gamete is very, very small in size. When compared to male and female gamete, male gamete is 100 times smaller than the female gamete. That is a oogamous type. The sex organs are produced on the prothallus. So in oogamous type, the female gamete are non-motile, male gamete are motile. The sex organs are produced in the prothallus. Already I told you, no? Here. So prothallus, it forms the antheridium and oligonium. Antheridium is a male sex organ, oligonium is a female sex organ. The male sex organ, that is antheridia, and the female sex organ, that is oligonia, is formed. It is antheridia, it is oligonia. Parity is present in the prothallus, gametophyte. So this gametophyte is developed from the spore. The spore is formed from spore mother cell. Where the spore mother cell is present? Inside the sporangium. Where the sporangium is present? In the sporophyll. What is a sporophyll? That a fertile leaf is called sporophyll. Okay, so the sporophytic plant body has the fertile leaf that contain sporangium. The sporangium, inside the sporangium, spore mother cell is present. This spore mother cell is undergoing the reduction division as a form the haploid spore. This haploid spore germinate to form the multicellular chordate haploid and independent gametophytic prothallus. This prothallus is contained antheridia and oligonium. Antheridia is a male sex organ, oligonium is a female sex organ. So antheridia is produced spirally coiled multiflagellator. That's right, I already told you. Multiflagellator anthrozoite. So that is a structure of antheridia. Okay, so here the antheridia, it will be protected by the sterile layer. And it is a multiflagellator anthrozoite, spirally coiled anthrozoite. Oligonia is a flat cell. So that is oligonia, it's a flat cell with a broader venter. So broad venter. So there is a venter region. It's a narrow neck region. Broad venter region. So the broad venter region is only have the egg cell. And the narrow neck region is called the ventral canal cell and neck canal cell. The venter possesses the egg or ovum. And the neck contains neck canal cell. Okay, that is a neck canal cell. It's a ventral cell. Ventral canal 1, 2, 3. That is a neck canal cell. It's a egg. That is a haploid. Water is essential for fertilization, like in bryophyte. So here also water is essential. After fertilization, the diploid zygote is formed. It undergoes the mitotic division as a formed embryo. This embryo later differs into root, stem and leaves. Okay, so here the antrodium is released, the multiflagellate structure. It will be reached to egg after the fertilization is over or syngamy. Syngamy or fertilization, the fusion of male and female gamete. The process is called fertilization or syngamy. As soon as the zygote is formed, later the zygote, it undergoes the repeated mitotic division as soon as formed the embryo. So the formation of embryo is occurring in the tetrapyta. That's why the tetrapyta is come under the embryopyta. Next, another type of the reproduction, that is apogamy and apospory. So what is apogamy? What is apospory? Apogamy, away from fusion of gamete. Okay. So it is the development in haploid sporopyte without the gamete. The development of haploid sporopyte. Actually, sporopyte is a diploid. But here the development of haploid sporopyte without the gamete and the syngamy. Syngamy means fertilization. Without fusion of gamete. Okay. From the vegetative cell of gametophyte, that is prothallus. The prothallus will develop into haploid sporopyte. That is a apogamy. Apospory. That means without meiosis. The apospory is the development of diploid gametophyte without meiosis. So spory, apospory means the spore must be formed after meiosis. But here the meiosis is never occur. So the diploid spore is directly develop into the diploid gametophyte. And without meiosis and spore formation, the vegetative and non-productive cell of sporopyte. Okay, so here is a plant body. It produces a haploid spore. It produces a gametophyte. So the fusion of gamete is formed. The adult sporopyte. That is a regular state. But here what is happened? The gametophyte, it will be directly developed into. It's a without the formation of antheria and argonia, that is a zygote formation. Directly it will be formed to what? The sporophyte. So gametophyte is a haploid. So it directly develops into haploid sporophyte. So here haploid spore. That means after meiosis the haploid spore is formed. But not like that. In apospory, the adult sporopyte it directly develops into the diploid gametophyte without meiosis. So gamete means away. Spore means without meiosis. Okay. Thank you, student. That's all about the general character of tetrapyte is formed. So next class we are going to see the classification of tetrapyte and economic importance of tetrapyte. Thank you.